On the way to Alamogordo, New Mexico. This is Tuesday morning, September the 3rd, 2024 at 8:20 a.m. It shows to be 61 degrees. And this is highway, 48? We're going southwest to Alamogordo. It's about an hour drive from Carrizozo to Alamogordo. Why am I driving to Alamogordo? Well, I need to go drop off a package at Staples to be delivered UPS to my son in New Braunfels, Texas. And then I need to go by a dermatologist, make an appointment. I was going to try to do it over the phone and the internet, but every time I try to do that, you know, they ask questions like what kind of medications you take and all kind of stuff. I don't take any, and that always raises a red flag. Sometimes the system won't take it, and I have to go by the office and do it anyway, so I'll just go by a dermatologist office in Alamogordo and get that done. Enough said about that. Just walk in and do it, right? And then, big deal, I got to go to Walmart and get a few grocery items, get some gasoline, and go by the 10th Street Lowe's grocery store, beautiful store in Alamogordo, and get a few grocery items. And I know you wanted to know that, and that's the only reason I did this video. Very important that you know what I'm doing every day. But I've got me some green tea, and I've got me some dark chocolate and almonds and other stuff, mixed nuts. I'm one of the nuts. And it's a beautiful drive, man. It's just a straight shot. The only time you slow down is when you get to Tularosa, which is about 10 miles from Alamogordo, and then you take the loop around, you know, like you're going to go around El Paso and drop off to, well, in my case, I'll drop off to go to Staples because it's not too far from 10th Street, and on we go. But yeah, what I was doing, I was out walking this morning, and I thought, now, is there anything I could do to make my life more enjoyable? And one of the things I can do is go to a dermatologist, because it gives me peace of mind, because I did have some old melanoma, that old bad stuff, skin cancer, and we got rid of it. But that doesn't mean it doesn't come back, or you can't, another area won't pop up. But you know, at 79 years old, it's a good idea to have those things checked out anyway, because it doesn't hardly cost, Medicare takes care of most of it, or nearly all of it in my case, because I've already met the deductible. And so, yeah, we're good. What else is going on, guys? Well, I've been thinking about the winter also. You know, I'm gonna do some winter things for my RV, maybe. I haven't ordered anything yet, but I'll probably order one of those hoses that's insulated and has a, you plug it into a 110 outlet and it keeps the hose warm so it can't freeze in the winter. But we'll see. But you know, it was 48 this morning. Old man winter's knocking on the door and saying, okay, start getting yourself ready. And I was thinking about the Native Americans, or the Aboriginal people in the USA many years ago. About this time, they'd start heading south. Why? Well, if you walk about 20 miles a day and you got to go 800 miles or 1,000 miles, it's going to take you 6 weeks to 2 or 2.5 months, you know, walking. I hear you. Well, you know, they do the Continental Divide Trail. You know, that's 3,000 miles from the New Mexico border to the border of Canada and the USA, and they average 20 miles a day. That's what they try to average, so that when they leave the border of New Mexico and Mexico in May or April, some of them leave in April, that they will arrive before the snow falls in the Rockies in October. Yeah, that's a long walk, isn't it? I'm telling you. But anyway, it's a beautiful drive here. As you can see, not much traffic. It's Tuesday morning. Yeah, nice. This may be, is this highway, I think this is highway 54, right? Did I say 48? I think this is 54. 48 goes from Capitan to Ruidoso. 54 goes north and south from Alamogordo and points north Actually, you can go all the way to El Paso. But it's a nice day, nice drive, and what else can I tell you? I don't know how hard it's going to be to get a dermatologist appointment in Alamogordo. It looks like they've got two major dermatology type places, maybe more, but there's two that I'm interested in. And I thought, well, hell, I got all day. I'll just go by the office and let them tell me if they're taking patients or not. And if they are, well, I'll just go ahead and do all their stuff right there and let the girl fill it in herself, you know? And what else? That's about it. And then the next thing I'll do, probably early next year, will be to find an ophthalmologist in Alamogordo and make an appointment so that I'll go there once a year and get my eyes examined. Why do I go to an ophthalmologist as opposed to an optometrist? Well, now that I've had the cataract surgery, the ophthalmologist has the equipment needed, if necessary, to clean the artificial lens in my right eye. Even though it's no problem right now, you never know. Because they do, even though you have a lens put in, sometimes they cloud up and they have issues, you know, but they can do a little laser cleanup that take but a few seconds. And you don't have to, you know, have anybody drive you or anything like that. There's a boy on a four-wheeler, or a lady. So anyway, what else? Yeah, we're averaging 32 miles a gallon. Tachometer shows about 1,800 RPMs approximately at 60 miles an hour in my Ford Transit Connect minivan. I've got 6,114.3 miles on it. And so far, knock on wood, it's been a very, very interesting little vehicle. I enjoy it. Because I've got a bed behind me and refrigerator. In fact, I've got the refrigerator on now, cooling down, so that when I get to the grocery store, those items like yogurt and frozen blueberries that need to be kept cool, I can put in the refrigerator. We're good. That's kind of handy, isn't it? Yeah, and I got one of those portable power packs. It's 1,000 watts. But I also plug it in. There's a 12 volt outlet in the back there, and I plug in a charger to that, and then it plugs into the portable power unit, and so it's charging it while it's running my refrigerator. So when I get back home, I have a full portable power pack. This road right here is pretty rough. You're probably hearing it in the mic. It's a little noisy part of the road here. But we'll cruise along here for a while and let you see this beautiful nothingness. Beautiful to me. Yeah, the old man fall, I guess you'd say. Old lady or old man fall kind of slipped in here this morning out there in the middle of the desert where I live near Carrizozo. 48 degrees. Yeah, it was a little crispy. Had to bundle up when I went walking because we had about a 8 to 10 mile an hour wind from the east. But anyway, guys, just wanted to give you a heads up and do a driving video. Some of you enjoy these. I apologize for the noisy road. It ends right up here. You know, it takes up a few minutes of the video, and then just about the time I end it, we get on a smoother section. But we're not far from the turnoff to Three Rivers Petroglyph site. It's up here on the left. They got some camping sites there for RVs. They only have two, or maybe three, is it two or three, full hookup, or not, I don't even know, I think it's just water and electric, could be wrong on that. I've only stayed there a couple of times at the hookup sites. The other times I just dry camped because the weather was really, really good. So, yeah. And there are some interesting petroglyphs, or what do you call it? Glyphs, is that a good word? It's pretty interesting. But when you're there, be careful and watch for the rattlesnakes, because they got them there. I've seen them. I mean, at a distance. You see, right here where the road color kind of changes, it'll be a little smoother right in here. It'll be rougher in that you bounce around a little more. But see, it's not quite as noisy. You got noisy roads and quiet roads. This is a fairly quiet road for a while. But anyway, guys, thumbs up, carpe diem, adios, bye-bye, buy anything you want, anytime. Use the link to Amazon products in the description of all of my videos. Why? Doesn't cost you a penny. Just click on the link, zip over to Amazon and buy what you were gonna buy. And it doesn't cost you a penny. Drink plenty of water, stretch, walk, stand guard at the door of your mind, and enjoy your life the best way you can. Keep your health. Yeah, enjoy life. Adios, bye-bye.